While Donald Trump has worked to build relationships across the Arab world, the reality is that he and his party have cultivated a hostility toward Arabs and Muslims that has a very damaging effect on our communities here in the United States. It's had an effect in terms of attitudes, in terms of behaviors, and in terms of policies. In the first place, there's a deeply rooted partisan split that has developed, with Republicans and Democrats being mirror images of each other on this issue. A recent poll we conducted showed that even after Trump's Middle East visit, by a margin of 3-1, Republicans had a hostile attitude towards Arabs and Muslims. On the other hand, Democrats had a positive attitude toward Arabs and Muslims. The split carries over into attitudes towards Arab Americans and American Muslims. Over 60% of Democrats have a favorable view of Arab Americans and American Muslims, while Republicans have only a 30% favorable attitude toward both communities. It's not just a matter of liking us. The attitudes shape the public's tolerance toward how we're treated. Over 60% of Trump supporters, for example, feel that Arab Americans and American Muslims ought to be racially profiled by law enforcement. The same number feel that you ought to ban immigrants from Muslim countries. And the same number still have no confidence that an American Muslim had a government job, that he could be trusted to do that job. Meanwhile, the hostile rhetoric and the smearing of Arab Americans and American Muslims has also created sharp increases in reported hate crimes against both communities. In fact, the sharpest of any of the groups measured by law enforcement statistics. Because we know how painful it is, because we know the damage it can do, we at AAI are committed to fighting to improve our political discourse in this country and also to protect our community against the smearing and the hate.